the last problem of Unit 3, we find a population faced with a malaria epidemic, which is definitely very scary for everyone involved. Luckily, we're here to help them out. In order to slow the spread of the disease, we're going to make people start using mosquito nets in their houses so they can avoid being bitten as often. We're going to introduce the nets after 100 days, and they immediately decrease the probability of a person getting bitten by 90%, as we can see from the constant that we've defined right here called bite reduction by net. Bites per day a mosquito tells us that every person gets bitten by each mosquito 0.1 times per day. Now, when a mosquito bites a human, there's a chance of two different things happening that are of particular interest to us. Now, if the mosquito has malaria, it can give the disease to the human. Or if the human has malaria, then he or she can give it to the mosquito. The probability of either of these things happening is shown right here. Once infected, it takes a human approximately 70 days to recover. At this point, it's important to notice that mosquitoes only live for 10 days. Clearly, humans also have a finite lifetime, but compared to mosquitoes, we might as well be immortal, even if we do end up with malaria. So that's what we're going to pretend for the purposes of this problem. Now, we can model a scenario like this. We need two separate bubble diagrams, one for the mosquito population and one for the human population. The mosquito life cycle is kind of a sad one. As soon as they are born, they fall into the S part of the population, the susceptible part. From here, they can become infected, and then eventually they die. There's no option for them to become susceptible again. A couple of other things to keep in mind about mosquitoes. For one thing, they can't get malaria until after they're born. Second, only female mosquitoes can transmit malaria. So just pretend that all the mosquitoes that we're talking about in this problem are female. Now, this problem requires you to take into account all the factors affecting the infected population and to include them using the Ford-Euler method. Think critically, keep track of your units, and good luck. If you have any trouble at all, visit the forums.